good. Well, as I said the last time I talked, I think the most important thing for any team this time of year, but especially our team, is to reestablish the identity that this particular team is going to have for this year. And we've had two really good first practices. Carryover seems to be pretty good, especially with the younger players. The 12 new guys that came in, I think there's a few guys there that can probably help us in some way, but it's probably too early to know for sure exactly how that would be, what that would be, and how much that would be. But I think a good question for every player to ask themselves, you know, right now is, you know, what do you want in order to accomplish the goals and aspirations to be successful, but what are you willing to do it, I think is probably a better question. And we ask the players to invest in themselves, but sometimes, you know, you have to give a little something up. Very important to have the right recovery in terms of sleep, what you do off the field as well as what you do on the field. Sleep, how you hydrate, how you take care of yourself, how you eat, how you dissipate. All these things affect ability to recover, which affects performance, which in turn affects how effective a player you really are when you get out on the field. I think the acclimation program that we do right now is probably a good thing. 2 days in shorts, 2 days in shoulder pads, and then we can get into full pads. I think it's good for the players. We can do a lot of good teaching in these days in shorts, which I think we've been able to accomplish. And, you know, we want to make determinations as to who can play winning football relative to kind of intangibles that they play with, whether it's mental and physical toughness, whether it's ability to sustain effort, whether it's responsible to do your job, know what your job is, how to do it, why it's important to do it that way. All these things are important to being able to play winning football on a consistent basis, and that's what we're trying to focus on, to see how many guys we have on this team that can play winning football. And I think in doing that, as coaches, we don't want guys to be risk averse and be afraid to make mistakes. We want them to play fast, play hard, and learn from the mistakes that they make, and know that that's a good opportunity to improve. And as I said many times before, self-assessment is important. Ability to take correction is important, so that you can improve and get better. So I'm pleased with the staff, staff chemistry, the good teachers that we have on our staff. I think it's been really good so far, and hopefully we'll be able to continue to build on that.
Start up here, front row with John Zeter.
I know it's just August 5th, but what kind of impact does Coach Duvall have, Dable have on the offense and Jalen especially?
Well, I think Brian's done a really, really good job. He's a good teacher. I think the players have a lot of respect for him. He's very enthusiastic about what he does. Systematically, we've carried over a lot of things that we've done in the past, but the new additions that we made, he certainly has great teaching progression for. I think he does a great job of helping coach the other coaches so that they can do a good job of coaching the players. So specifically relative to Jalen, I think he's a very, very good quarterback coach. I think it's helped Jalen fundamentally. I think he's got a better understanding and confidence, especially in the passing game, of what he needs to do and what's expected of him. And I see a lot of improvement from that standpoint.
Back over here with Chandler.
To kind of follow up on that, Nick, when we talk to the players, they talk about how Brian is so organized and he's so businesslike. How does his approach to maybe his day-to-day operations mesh with what you want for your assistants to do?
Well, I think that's exactly what we want them to do. We want to be well organized in our presentation to how we teach the players. I think conceptually that helps players understand and learn more efficiently and effectively. And, you know, of all the people that I've ever been with, you know, Bill Belichick probably does this as well as anybody. So For Brian to have been in that system and that organization for a long time, I think is reflected in his organization and his teaching progressions that he has for the players.
Back over here to Michael.
Kind of along that same line, what's the biggest difference, I guess, from him coming, being in the NFL, being pretty much his whole career in the NFL, what's the biggest difference when he comes back to the college game?
Well, I think that there are some differences in the game. I think the biggest thing is the rule about being downfield, being able to throw RPOs. The kind of play action passes are a little bit different because linemen can be 3.5 yards downfield. But I think because we have a good staff overall, and we made some additions with some people who have had a lot of success, you know, with that type of offense, it's been fairly easy to learn and implement into our system that we've had in the past, for Brian to learn and to be able to implement it in the system that we have right now. So I don't think it's a big issue. It's all football, and it all comes down to ability to execute, which is fundamentally how you block, how you tackle, how you run routes, what the quarterback reads to get rid of the ball, how we pass protect. So those things are pretty much the same at both levels. So the one thing is probably the thing that's a little bit different, but that's not something that we've had an issue implementing.
Go back in the back to Cecil.
Coach, I guess a little off the wall, but is there any possibility that Trayvon Diggs could have an offense-defense role this fall?
No, we're not really going down that road right now. We're really focused on trying to develop him as a corner on our team. So we're not going down that road right now. We really feel good about the young receivers that we have. So we're giving them as many reps as they can, and hopefully at some point this season they'll be able to make a contribution. But I think right now Trayvon is focused on one thing, which I think is important, especially with young players, to define a role so that they can be effective in that role. So can I be off the wall for a minute? And are we WIA over there with the crutch? I mean, you know what that means, right? Wounded in action? I mean, what's up?
I'm questionable for next Saturday.
You better not miss treatment then.
I'll be the ginger will track me down. Also, the other, even more off the wall, in the past you've had success using a defensive lineman in a goal line or a heavy offensive package. Is there anybody that's got that skill set?
Well, I think we have some guys that probably do. Right now, we haven't even done goal line and short yardage yet. So, you know, that's and that depends a little bit on the players that we have on offense. But I do think we do have a couple guys defensively that can do that. We toured around with it a little bit in the spring, and we'll see how it goes here in the fall.
On the back of Brian.
Going back to Brian, how much do you think his defensive background as a player and also early on in his coaching career has influenced his kind of his offensive strategy?
Well, I think any good offensive coach really understands defense. One of the things that I see in a lot of offensive coaches is they're very systematic in terms of what they do, but their knowledge of defense is maybe, and how they attack things. If you're playing a certain coverage on defense and you really understand how that coverage is being taught and implemented and what the keys are for the defensive players, then you have a better chance to exploit that by how you attack it. With the patterns and what gives it a problem. I think that's been probably the contribution that I've been able to make to our offense is my experience of being a secondary coach for more years than I want to admit to. I can always say this is the hardest thing against that. And I think when you've been a defensive player and you have that understanding, I think that only helps you be able to do that effectively.
Sean Dion, obviously coming in his senior year, he had the injury last year, What's the progression you've seen from him, and what kind of year do you anticipate him having?
Well, he's worked really hard. I think he's doing really well. He's done very well in the 2 days of camp. I think he's confident that he's healthy. I think any player that's coming back off of an injury is going to make day-to-day progress in terms of getting back to 100%, but he's very close to that. He's got a very, very good understanding of our defense, what we do, the concepts of how we play things, and I think that's going to benefit him. But I also feel that there's some other guys at linebacker that are really making some nice progress, so the competition at that position, I think, will help everybody get better.
Nick, I guess there are different philosophies on what kind of opponent teams like to open up with. You'll open up with some very stout opponents in your history. What are the benefits to opening up with a really tough team, and how difficult is it to get a team ready to play a game like that right up front?
Well, I think it's challenging to get your team ready to play anybody, but obviously when you play a really, really good team, they present a lot of challenges. That's why they're a good team. So that sort of goes without saying, in my opinion, that but the positive side of that is the players are more into it. They're more focused because they understand who they're playing and they have a respect for the quality of team that they're playing. I think the benefit is it helps the off-season program, it helps spring practice, it helps summer conditioning, because the players are really looking forward to playing in a game where they have a tremendous amount of respect for their opponent. I think on the other side of it, it goes a long way to tell us as coaches and our team where we are in our progression of where we're capable of getting to. Because you played a really good opponent. Sometimes if you play a not-so-good opponent in the first game, maybe some of the things that are real issues and problems don't surface, and therefore you don't address them. So I've always liked playing a good opponent because of the effect that it has in the offseason. I think the players have really good focus in fall camp, getting ready for that game. And I think from a coaching standpoint, it certainly tells you where your team is when you play a good opponent.
Got two more, Alex.
As a defensive staff, how much can continuity kind of help from 1 year to the next moving forward? And where do you feel like Jeremy kind of took another step as a defensive coordinator last year?
Well, I think Jeremy was a very good coordinator at Florida State and Georgia, playing a similar system to what he sort of learned here. So I don't think it was a tremendously difficult transition for him to implement what we did here, but I think he did a fabulous job. I think statistically we were better in a lot of categories than even the year before. Granted, we had a lot of good players, but he got the good players to play well, and I think that's the key. I think that the fact that we have all the coaches on defense, the continuity on defense, the understanding how we coach things, how we do things, probably is a benefit. And it's probably a benefit with all the young players that we have and all the players that we have to replace that hopefully will enhance the development of those players so that we can get them where they need to be to play effectively, you know, this year.
Okay,
we'll
finish up in the back of the
room. Coach, you're known as one of the top coaches in America in player development. How important is it to you to hire coordinators, other coaches that are good at just doing that?
Well, I think that's what makes a good coach. I'm not talking about myself now, but I'm talking about the people on your staff that, first of all, can relate well to the players, can get the players to buy into the things that they need to do to be all that they can be, and to sacrifice the things that they need to give up so that they can do that. To invest in themselves so they have the best chance to be successful. I think it's important that you're a good fit on the staff. When I say that, I mean you get along well with your peers. You buy into the system that you're trying to teach so that everybody's committed.